So today, we are going to, you are going to come with me, if you don't mind, to the high street so we check out what is new. Hello, this is Dear Denise Diary and you're welcome. My name is Denise. Today, I decided to go down the high street and check out what is happening in the high street. Check out what is new. Today is the 17th of June. Today is the 17th of June. Since Monday, the 15th of June, here in the UK, our lockdown restrictions have been eased a bit. I mean, for the past couple of weeks, but since Monday, non-essential shops are now allowed to open. So we are talking about shops like Primark, Marks and Spencer, Boots is now open. I mean, Boots has been open all throughout because they have essentials, what they consider essentials, such as medicines and vitamins. And Boots has been one of the shops that has been helping a lot during this pandemic. So they have been opened, just the health side being open. So go to Boots and see what's going on there. Clarks is open. A lot of shops are open on the high street. So I thought we'd go down there and see what's happening. Basically just see which shops have opened and which shops have not opened. And also what has retailers put in place to ensure that the customers are confident enough to come into their shop to shop with them, considering their current health situation, where everybody's worried about, you know, catching the virus, etc. We want to see what the retailers have been able to put in place for us, the consumers, to have confidence enough to go into the shop to buy things physically. I know we've all been buying online. It's nice to sit at home and get your things delivered, but sometimes you want to go in the shop, want to try our shoes on, you want to see what's going on in there, you want to see other people. So we go in there and see what measures they've put in place for us to feel confident enough to go into their shop and shop safely, and then just see how busy it is. I mean, on Monday, when I was going to work, I saw there was a large queue on the high streets, especially for Primark. Really, really long queue. People just want to get into Primark to shop. And the abandoned high street is now thriving. It's busy. There you see people walking down the shopping centers, etc. So let's go check out and see how the high street is doing. So yeah, so come with me to my local high street and just check out a few shops and see what's going on there. So here we are in the town center. So we start off with Marks and Spencer. At the entrance, there are stickers on the floor guiding you on where to stand to ensure social distancing. First thing is a hand sanitizing station. There was security standing offering hand sanitizer should you miss the station. There were signs up reminding us of the guidelines and the protocols of the shop with regards to implementing safe measures for customers. There were not many people in the shop today whilst I was there. The food section there is still open and has been throughout the lockdown. There were a few sales items, but by the week ending of my filming, M&S had a rainbow sale with items going 50% off. I'm sure it's still going on right now. So if you're interested, pass by Marks and Spencer and pick up a few bargains. So as you can see the signs. I was just about to go to the checkout here. So out of Marks and Spencer is Primark.
That's the queue for Primark. There were not many people. It wasn't massive, but I was not ready to do that. I wasn't feeling it. So I just continued down. Isn't it a beautiful day? And there we are, just walking down the shopping center. This is the most I've seen of people in the shopping center since the reopening. Well, I haven't been here much, so. And this is Clarks to our left. There's a massive change in Clarks. All the sitting areas have been removed, and all the items placed on shelves to the walls, leaving a massive area in the middle of the store to ensure social distancing. I must visit the store to see more of what they have. And then I'm just walking down here. As you can see the banners for Debenhams. There are a couple of people in the queue there. So I think I'm gonna join the queue here. So I got chatting with the lady in front of me there for a little while, and we just stood there for about 15 minutes and before the shop got open, because I think I got here about 15 minutes before opening time. I can see someone opening the doors now. I think we're getting ready to go in. So just as you enter, you see the man standing there. He's got a visor on and gloves and everything on, trying to point you into the right direction to have the to put a hand sanitizer at the station over there as well. And then we go in. So the man at the door also reminds you to keep 2 meters apart whilst in the shop. Also, all the changing rooms are locked, they're not in use, so you're not able to try your clothing on. You can, however, take them home, try it on. If you're not happy with it, you can return them to the shops and either exchange them or refund them. So around the shop, there are a lot of signs in black and yellow reminding you to social distance. So ahead of us is Bobbi Brown. That's the makeup stations area. You have Chanel, Estee Lauder, Clinique, etc. And unfortunately, they all closed because you're not able to have any makeup testing. They're not allowed to test any makeup on you. You cannot even have makeup testers to take home to go try. I don't know why. I think on this day it was only Clinique that had someone manning their station, and this is what she explained to us. She can only sell something to you if you know what you want and you know your shade. She cannot color match or anything like that, and you still have to stay 2 meters away from her. They all had masks on, and yeah. Thank you. So as I walked around the shop, I was really hoping to see more hand sanitizing stations, just because Debbie Nams is such a big shop, and you may have touched a lot of things in the shop, and you just will feel a little bit better if you could put on another hand sanitizer halfway through your shopping. Walking around the shop, there are a few items which are out of season, as you can see there, so they've put them on 70% off sale, so they can push them out of the shop. I mean, we are in the summer season, so I think the next set of clothing that should be coming in soon will be autumn stuff, so they need to get rid of the previous winter items. And then also the summer items as well, really. Debbie Nams normally offer bra fitting sessions as well, just to ensure that your bra fits properly and help you with choosing your bra size. This service is not available at the moment due to their current health situation, so the fitting rooms are shut. Like you can see, even the tail over here is shut, just so you know you cannot use that area. Here we are in Boots. Boots has a one-way system. So in front of us, you can see the arrow going. That's for the exit. and over here is coming in. So you go in this way. That gentleman coming is coming the wrong direction. He should be on the other side. That's one of the problems with this new thing. When something is new, it takes us a bit of time to adjust or even pay attention. So at the makeup session, there are no testers. You just have to buy what is available there. And I guess if you buy makeup and you go open it, you cannot return it, obviously. So yeah, everything is on display, you can touch. I also forgot to mention, on entry to Boots, there's also hand sanitizing station. The security man at the door also has a hand sanitizer with him, and he can help you with some hand sanitizer as well. And then they also tell you the protocol of the shop to ensure that you keep 2 meters apart. As you saw over there, I was not able to keep 2 meters apart with some of the gentlemen over there. One was standing, so that means you have to wait till the person moves before you go on. And also with that man coming the wrong direction as well, you just end up you know, coming close to people. Limited amounts of people are allowed entry into the shop at one time. I think the security men, as they allow people in, they count, and when it reaches the maximum amount of people they want in the shop, they make the others queue. So when people go out, then you can go in. This shop offers self-service machines, so you can check out by yourself. That has been shut. The alternative entrance and exit over there has also been shut, so you're not able to use that. Now for their checkout area, you can see on the floor it's all been mapped out 2 meters apart, and yeah, that it helps, especially with people who don't know the measurement for 2 meters. And as you can see, this is the exit, and this is normally the high-end area for makeup. They're all not working. There's only 2 stations that were working. I think it was Estee Lauder and number 7, which is Boots brand. The Apple shop is open for business. Pandora is open. River Island, however, was not open. I don't know whether it's just my high street that is not open, or if all River Islands are not open. So our next stop is the body shop. There were only 2 staff in there, one at the door and one at the till. The one at the door was offering hand sanitizers. So you go in. There are no testers as well in the body shop. So you just literally have to pick up what you need and go pay for it. Thank you.
payment and refund in the basement only at the moment, and then card payment only on this floor and upstairs.
Okay.
And our footing will just shut. We're just asking you to try anything on the shop floor as well.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. There's not much change in layout in H&M. However, there are signs on the floor, black and white signs reminding you to keep safe and also keep 2 meters apart. As you saw, there is a one-way system in H&M as well, one way in and the other way out. Within the shop itself, I did not see any hand sanitizer anywhere, but on my exit, the lady at the exit point offered me a hand sanitizer should I choose to use it again. She also had a little pad, sort of like a tablet, where she kept adding up. I think she's counting the number of people entering and exiting the shop. There were lots of tips outside, 2 meters apart, helping people who are queuing to stay apart. This is one of the small shopping malls, and there's hand sanitizer outside or on the entry. Right now I'm just trying to get to TK Maxx. So I think that's really good. Just walking around, there are hand sanitizers in this little shopping mall. You can just pop some in your hand and then you go. You see the floors also have a one-way system to help people go one way and the other, so you're not mixing with others. So there's a queue. And this is TK Maxx with a long maze of a queuing system to get into the shop. Getting closer to the entrance, you see the tapes on the floor as well, helping people to stay 2 meters apart. When you get closer to the entrance, there's someone standing there who gives you hand sanitizer, also tells you the protocol of the shop, tells you to ensure that you stay 2 meters apart. They're also counting the number of people going in, so one person in, one person out, and it's also got one way entry and one way exit. TK Maxx has put in a few changes at the glasses station. There is a spray, I think it's antibacterial spray in there, and there are tissues provided as well, so you could use it to sanitize the glasses before you wear them and after as well. There used to be a large table that has very loose makeup stuff on it, where people pick out like eyebrow pencil, lip liners, eyeliners, lipsticks, and etc. They've all been put into clear plastic pouches and locked, so the individual very small items, they've put them in pouches and put them away, so you can pick it, take it to the till, and then they will unlock it and sell it to you. I think that is to ensure that a lot of people are not handling it, so I think that's a really good thing.
We're back home. Everything has been sanitized. Very important. Everything that comes into this house, sanitized at the door. So it's all sanitized. It's here. We're going to talk about it. But to be honest, this was not the plan. The plan was not to shop. We were just going to look around. But a few things caught my eye and I bought them. Do I feel guilty? Tiny bit, but hey. These things happen. So I have got my tea here, and Let's see what I bought. Green tea, lovely. So, in Marks & Spencer, I bought a vest for B. I always buy all his school uniforms and things from Marks & Spencer. I like the quality that I get. I'm sure maybe there are other qualities that are nice, but I haven't tried anything else yet. It's usually Marks & Spencer. So I got him some vest because he's growing out of his vest. My poor Baba is growing. I really don't want him to grow. So cute. And I got him a belt as well. So from Marks & Spencer, I actually went to Boots, as you saw. So in Boots, I picked this up, the Maybelline mascara. I got that one and the falsies, and then I got mascara primer. It was 3 for $2, so I picked these things up in Boots. And then in the Body Shop, I love the Body Shop. I use some of their products a lot. I picked up, the other day I went there, I was given a little tester sachet of this, and I really like it, so I decided to get another one. Ooh, it doesn't really open that way, but I thought I could. Yeah, it's got little beads and things in there. It scrubs really well. I have normal to combination skin, they said, combination to oily, whatever. Combination to oily, I thought it was, but I was told it's normal to combination when I got tested. I went to the shop and got tested. Anyway, so it's normal on my cheeks, and then in my T-zone, it gets really, really oily, and especially in the summer. So in the summer, I do like to use this tea tree stuff on my face, which works really well, and I normally get them from the Body Shop. So I decided to pick up one of that, and then I also like their seaweed deep cleansing gel wash. So I got one of that as well. I did try to go into Primark. The queue was ridiculous. There was no way I was going to stand there. I had already, you know, queued up in for Debenhams. You know, I wasn't going to queue up for Primark. I know Primark opened early. I'm not sure exactly what time they opened, but I think by 9 o'clock they were open. There was such a long queue because Marks & Spencer was also open. I went in there, got my stuff. Then when I tried to go into Debenhams, it was 9:45 when I got to Debenhams, and it was not open, and I saw that they're opening at 3:50. So I queued up for about 15 minutes. And I was the third person in the queue. When they opened up, there was a very long queue and a lot of people went in. I mean, Debenhams is quite big, so a lot of people are allowed to go in at a time. So yeah, Primark, no, I really, really wanted to go into Primark just to see the layout and see what is going on in there. Maybe one of these days we'll do that after the craze, because right now I think everybody wants to shop. Everybody has missed going on the high streets, and especially with Primark, they don't have an online shop. So people, you know, to get something from Primark, you've got to go into the shop. You can't get it online. So yeah, I really want to go in there and see exactly how they have changed, if they have at all. So so in Debenhams, what did I get? I got this for my little man, for my munchkin, and I got this bag for myself. it's from June. I had seen this bag already before the lockdown. I really liked it. I thought it was really cute. It's just a little cute bag to you know, go around with. And yeah, before the lockdown, and I couldn't go into the shop to get it. So today I saw it, I remembered it, and I picked it up. So it's cute. It actually has a long strap as well. That's this one in here. Yeah, I've taken all the papers out and I've sanitized everywhere, trust me. So yeah, TK Maxx. Now, everyone yesterday, literally everybody that I walked across, or I walked past, or I walked by, or I saw walking, or was on the road, was holding a TK Maxx bag. So I was like, what is going on in TK Maxx? Are they giving free stuff or something nobody's told me about? I need to get into it. Anyway, so today I went into TK Maxx just to see what's going on. I picked up a few things. Well, there were no freebies, but you know, they did still have good stuff. So I picked up a couple of things. I bought this for my baking, like I don't have enough of them already. I got a pizza cutter, which we all know what it is. I bought this this konjac sponge. It was only 90p, which is quite good. I love using them. They're so soft for your face. I also picked up washcloth. Well, not cloth, gloves. Wash gloves, washing gloves. I like these as well. And then also I got this shower cap, which is 90p. Yeah. Also clean down. And like I don't have enough shower cap, another one. Yeah, why not? It's only 90p. I think that's why there were people there. Probably Monday and Tuesday, a lot of people went in to clear out all the bargains. I also got this measuring jug because I like cooking. I've got a lot of these, but I still keep buying them. I don't know why. I really need to stop. I can't stop buying kitchen stuff. It's ridiculous. I need to stop. Yeah, this was $2.99, so I picked this up. And then I bought this bowl. I bought this bowl just because it says here that it can withstand temperatures of minus 40 degrees to plus 300 degrees. So I think I said, oh my, this would be perfect for like double boiling and stuff. Yeah, and I like the fact that it's all frosty. Usually it's clear, isn't it? So I bought one of that. And then in this house we love pancakes. Oh my god, we love pancakes. So I bought we love pancakes, and I have 10,000 pans. I'm always looking for new pans, but this pan is specifically for pancakes. Yes, I do have one that was meant specifically for pancakes, but this is bigger, okay? That's my excuse. This is bigger. This is it. Yeah. It's lovely. It comes in with a little spatula there to sort of turn turn the pancake, and a little roller for like really thin pancakes crepes, they call it in France, or like that. So I'll be using it to see. So basically that's all that I bought. So I didn't really go too crazy. I don't really need much, and there's a lot of discounts going on out there. So if you need something, go out there, go to the shops, stay safe. Make sure you adhere to the rules. 2 meters between people. If you're going on the bus, you need a mask. Otherwise, they will not allow you into the bus. And it's best to use contactless instead of cash. If you exceed the contactless limit, I think they've actually increased the contactless limit. It used to be 30. I remember the other day I bought something during the lockdown. It was £40 or so, and I could still use the contactless because they had increased their contactless threshold, so you could use that. Yeah, otherwise, I mean, there's always the pin, but just make sure that you sanitize, you keep safe, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did like it, give me a thumbs up. If there's anything else that you'd like me to do, please let me know in the comments, and I shall try my best to do that. So like, subscribe if you enjoyed the video. All right, thank you for snooping around my diary. You take care and keep safe out there. Bye.